गुड मॉर्निंग टॉल, एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके,
यस सर, ऑडिबल।
थैंक यू। आई थिंक लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड, इज स्क्रीन विजिबल? सो आई थिंक एवरीबडी हैव टू बी सीरियस नाउ बिकॉज एग्जामिनेशन डेट है डिक्लेयर्ड एंड वी हैव टू कवर आई थिंक six unit number 6 today we are going to complete, so two units we have to complete in next 5 to 6 hours, so everybody have to be punctual and here response, whenever I ask response everybody have to give the quick response. So last lecture we have start come near about to complete the impulse water turbine. This is a example is what Pelton turbine. So this PPT I am going to I have designed a little bit air PPT so that it will be useful. So turbine is a device which will give mechanical energy output, electrical generator. So this hydraulic turbine means hydraulic energy is going to be converted into mechanical energy, that we have learned two lectures, classification, type of energy at inlet, name of inventor, that is Francis Pelton Kaplan, type of energy means impulse turbine, reaction turbine, direction, axial flow, radial flow, mixed flow, position of turbine shaft, head, low head, medium head and high head, specific speed, low specific speed, medium specific speed. Okay, so type of energy at inlet, impulse turbine, reaction turbine. Impulse turbine means pressure only, and the energy available at inlet of the turbine is only kinetic energy. So no pressure, both in both outlet as well as inlet pressure is same. Reaction turbine, if the head at the inlet of turbine, water possesses kinetic energy as well as pressure energy, and pressure is decreasing throughout the stages. This is example we have learnt also in turbine. So nozzle, okay, so impulse turbine, reaction turbine, Pelton turbine, Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine. Okay, so direction of the flow, turbine turbine tangential flow, radial flow. So tangential flow is Pelton, radial flow, axial flow is Kaplan, mixed flow is Francis. Okay, so this PPT I am going to mail you. Okay, so I got this good PPT, so I will share with you. So position of turbine shaft, vertical shaft turbine, horizontal shaft turbine, head available, high head, Pelton turbine, medium head, Francis, and low head, Kaplan. We have discussed. So low specific speed turbine, medium specific speed turbine, high specific speed turbine, it is Pelton, Francis, and Kaplan. So we have discussed this. So this is a construction. So on that day, we have taken from the book, but now it is Pelton turbine, dam is there, head race. Okay, so this is gross head, difference in between tail race and head race, that is a level of water in dam. Okay, upper surface level of water in dam and level of water in tail race. Okay, so that difference is called as gross head. Okay, and this is depending on this head, where turbines are low head, medium head, here high head turbines. Pelton is a high head turbine. The dam penstock is a big pipe, inlet pipe, big pipe. Nozzle is there, and this jet is coming. These are the buckets or vanes we call runner and turbine. So this is a Pelton device. So Pelton turbine, no draft to be required because pressure at inlet as well as outlet is atmospheric pressure. Various head and efficiency. So gross head we have defined. The difference between the head race level and tail race level when no water is flowing in, known as gross head. So difference generally is difference. So net head is frictional head is always there in between the pipe and water, so that we have to minus. Hydraulic efficiencies of turbine we have discussed on that day. It is defined as the ratio of power given by water to the runner of the turbine to the power supplied by the water at inlet of the turbine. So it is here defined as the ratio of power given of by water to the runner of turbine. Okay, to the power supplied by the water. So it is inlet power. Supplied means what? 1/2 kinetic energy. This is what in case here kinetic energy you can say here kinetic and power developed by runner. So we have discussed about this afterwards. The mechanical efficiency, ratio of power available at the shaft of the turbine to the power delivered to the runner. Volumetric efficiency, ratio of volume of water actually striking the runner, the volume of water supplied to the turbine. Because of some leakages, some water will go air waste. It is defined as ratio of power available at the shaft of the turbine to the power supplied by the water. So overall efficiency. Okay, so Pelton turbine efficiencies, etc. We have discussed a lot. energy available at the inlet of turbine is kinetic energy. Pressure at the inlet and outlet of turbine is atmosphere. Okay. So parts of Pelton turbine also were discussed. So we'll nozzle, okay, runner and buckets, casing and braking gear. So this is this PPT I'm going to share. So this is a runner, this is a bucket. So I think last year every good collection that authorized done. This is a bucket, hemispherical bucket is there of Pelton turbine. This is called a splitter, okay, so which splits that particular water flow striking on the splitter into two parts, in one hemispherical half shape and another is one half shape. So this is called a cup shaped bucket, like a cup. Therefore, it is called a cup shaped bucket. So this is a runner, okay, Pelton turbine. So converts kinetic energy alone. So casing is there to prevent the splashing, okay, and to prevent this part. So we have to do this casing, okay. Penstock, another bucket runner. So this is your self-explanatory braking jet to stop the turbine. Now we have come across up to this. So we have seen triangles and work on a Pelton turbine. So in general, triangle we have drawn for, okay. What is that triangle? So here it is going to be, here if you are considering as a bucket. Now in general, this is a general triangle. So here if you are, this will be V1 coming from the nozzle, okay. So this is inlet velocity triangle having two components. One is horizontal component, one is what? Vertical component. Vertical component we call it as a here VF1, okay. Okay, so at the same time this runner, this tangential is moving with some tangent, this vane or blade is moving with some velocity that we call it as a U. So this U is V1 having two components, VF1 and VW1. Am I right now? Everybody understanding? Please write. Please tell. This is a quick review I have taken of last two lectures. VW1. So this will be considered as U1 because some tangential velocity. So this diagram little bit we have to muggle, so no problem. Because we are having here less time. Basics I don't want to take, otherwise if you take basic too much then it will take. So this is V1, this is U1, this is V1's horizontal component is VW1, okay, and V1's vertical component is VF1, and this angle we are calling as alpha, okay. And this U1 and V1, they are relatively different, and this is going to be, we can call it as a here VR1. Am I right? This is our general triangle, inlet triangle. Line outlet is like this. So here it is the outlet, same. So it is VR2, V2, V2 vertical component is VF2, okay. This is VF2 and horizontal component is VW2. And whatever the V2 and this particular U2, okay. So these are differs by some component. It is called as VR2. So this will be angle phi, this will be beta, okay. So this angle we call it as a theta, vane angle. Theta is inlet and here inlet vane angle. Alpha is inlet blade angle or nozzle angle at inlet. This is here beta is nozzle angle at outlet. Theta is vane angle at inlet or blade angle at inlet, and phi is blade angle at outlet. So this is going to be our diagram. But Pelton turbine is a, anybody? Pelton turbine is anybody? Pelton turbine is anybody? What is example of Pelton? Which type of turbine? Tangential or radial? Pelton turbine is tangential or radial? Pelton turbine, anybody fast? I have taken revision fast so that we will take much more on this analysis part. Anybody? Pelton turbine is tangential flow turbine. Therefore, what will happen? Tangential means what? Here, this will be V1. V1 will be there, and there will be no component present as a VF1. So VF1 will be what? Zero. So here, what is that? all everything. This is going to be bucket is there. It is going to be bucket. And this v1 tangential means what? The whatever the velocity is there, it is horizontal component of that velocity is only present. The vertical component is not present. So the vf1 will be what? Zero. As or it is only present horizontal component or tangential component, vf1 is equal to zero. Then what will happen? V1 is equal to vw1. So v1 and vw1 are equal. Okay. So blade also moving in tangential direction. So u1 a to b is we are considering as u1. Okay. Then difference in between these two tangential component, these are only tangential component. So difference is only what? V1 minus u1. This will be what? Vr1. So this is a, for Pelton turbine, as it is tangential flow turbine, inlet velocity triangle looks like a line. There is no triangle; it is line only. Inlet, what we can call inlet here velocity triangle will be looks like a line. So inlet velocity. It will like a line only. Okay, then outlet, no problem. So outlet whatever is we considered. So here I will not draw now because it is there outlet of the triangle. So the inlet will be acting as a line. So this is a diagram for Pelton turbine, and jet is deflecting like this. So this is the jet is what like this here. 50% is like deflection. So this is called as what? Angle of deflection. So this I think you have drawn last lecture. Am I right? Or you want to draw now? That also you have drawn. Please react, respond. Suhas is there? Suhas, Nikita Power, other Shubha Nani. Okay, Shubha Mishingan. Yes, sir. Now understood all these things. Shall we proceed further? Or anybody have doubt? Anybody have doubt so that we can clear? Shall we proceed further? Okay, Pramod. Yes. Like this, I want a response. Okay, Dikshad. Okay. So now, on that day also we have discussed about this here. Here, gross head Hg minus Hf. Gross head will be Hg and Hf will be 4FL squared over 2GD, where d is the diameter of penstock. So only frictional head loss will occur in what? The penstock only. So diameter of penstock. So this is our Darcy Weisbach equation. So from this we can calculate Hf. Dear Darcy equation. Darcy equation. Okay, and diameter of wheel will be d. So here henceforth what? D star will be diameter of penstock. N is the speed of wheel in RPM. D diameter of jet. Then velocity of inlet, because whatever the dam is there, the dam's head is what? H. H head is available at dam. Therefore, we know from this is a vorifice meter, so 2gh. So velocity of jet at inlet. So this formula everybody have to remember. Write down. Velocity of jet at inlet will be root 2gh. So for Pelton turbine or every turbine, so velocity of jet at inlet will be given by root 2gh. Kinetic energy will be 1/2 ma² but v1 will be velocity of jet, because orifice we have drawn this diagram. We have now this here diagram. So it is like a orifice only. Water is flowing through pipe. So we are calculating the theoretic velocity through the turbine that through the orifice or through this particular penstock will be, this is the head available at inlet or gross head H, net head. Net head means Hg minus Hf. Okay. So root 2gh. So velocity at inlet of Pelton turbine is given by root 2gh. And here, whatever the wheel diameter is there. So this is a F where here we are calculating by penstock diameter, Hg, diameter of penstock. So write down these formulas. And tangential velocity u is equal to u1 is equal to u2 for Pelton turbine. So properties of Pelton turbine, you write down. What is that? Vf1 is equal to 0. For Pelton turbine, Vf1 is equal to what? 0. Then V1 is equal to Vw1. Okay, here it is there. Then u is equal to u1. Tangential velocity at inlet and outlet is same, because a pressure acting at inlet and outlet is atmosphere. So there is no change in velocity also. So u is equal to u1 is equal to u2 is equal to pi dn divided by 60. Okay. then D is diameter of runner, D star is diameter of penstock, N is speed of turbine RPM, and then alpha is equal to 0, theta is equal to 0. So these are the very important properties of Pelton turbine. I think from diagram we have, and this what? VR1 is equal to V1 minus E1 or V1 minus U. All these things are very important. So this is one VW1 alpha, U1, this is basic. Understood? This formula you have to remember. Have you noted down? This formula is, I'm going to mail you PPT, don't about the writer, but important points at least you should revise. You should go across. You should write that also. Drawn, tangent of TV is equal to U1 is equal to U2 is equal to pi dN divided by 60. V1 is equal to root 2 GH, inlet velocity of Pelton. H is gross head, which is HG minus HF. Shall we proceed further? Return and understand. Yes, over, please write down and respond fast. Okay, yes. Yes, Dikshad Mili, yes. But oh, not over, Dikshad Mili. Write-up is not over. Over, okay. Okay, now we'll proceed further. So from this, VR2 is equal to VR1. Curry has to VR2 is equal to VR1 if friction is not there. From the also triangular outlet, we have VR2 is equal to VR1. Okay. Then and VW2, VR2 is equal to VR1. But when friction is not there, and VW2 is equal to VR2 cos pi minus U2. Then the force exerted by that day, I think we have completed this. The force exerted by jet in turbine is equal to what? Rho AV1, which is mass flow rate. Okay. Or it is equal to in simplify mass into VW1. Actually, it is what? Minus VW2. Okay. Because whirl component is responsible for power generation, I told you. And horizontal vertical component is responsible for flow, that is VF1 and VF2. VF1 and VF2 are the flow component responsible for flow. Okay, and power generation, horizontal component, tangential direction component of V1 and V2, VW1 and VW2. But V1 direction is what? Actually, direction is this, their direction of VW2 and VW1 is upward. Therefore, it's minus. Therefore, minus one will become plus. So, rho AV1. VW1 plus VW2. Area of jet will be pi by 4 d square. This is the jet diameter. So diameter, rear notations you remember, d is small, d is what? Diameter of jet. Diameter of jet. Jet just nozzle mode another jet. That is what? Diameter of jet. Capital D is what? Anybody? Tie to capital D. Diameter of काय कौन सांगते
व्हील
डायमीटर
ऑफ द व्हील
व्हील और रनर करेक्ट रनर और व्हील करेक्ट डायमीटर ऑफ रनर ज्याच्यावर ते बकेट्स आपण माउंट केले रनर और व्हील ओके रनर म्हणू आपण थोडा व्हील ओके व्हील आणि डी स्टार मी लिहित नाही डी स्टार काय असतो त्याचा डायमीटर आहे आपण घेतला आतापर्यंत डायमीटर ऑफ स्वानी diameter of
penstock
diameter. Good, Nikhil and Shivani. Okay, then this is the fx. Now work done is equal to fx into u rho av1 into vw1 plus vw2. Ela apan makkas apan reserve overall component vw pun manat hoto steam turbine madhe ela apan vw manu shakta. Now vw1 plus vw2 into u newton meter per second. So this is called watt, and if it is divided by 1000, it is 1000. So this formula everybody have to write. I think last time I have written. Last time gadbadit apan ghetla pan we written. So power generated by Pelton turbine we have to calculate by formula rho AV1 into bracket VW1 plus VW2 into U. So this is we can calculate. Then okay, so rho AV1 into, so this derivation then simplification. ओके सो रो ए वी वन इंटू वी डब्ल्यू वन प्लस वी डब्ल्यू टू इंटू यू डिवाइड बाय काइनेटिक एनर्जी This hydraulic efficiency derivation. So it is I think here definition of what hydraulic efficiency. Eta hydraulic is the here hydraulic efficiency. It is what here kinetic energy of the turbine mv is okay. म्हणजे इथं काय आपण सॉरी एक मिनिट आपण पुढे आले होतो ओके And hydraulic efficiency is given by here he kinetic here power developed by runner rho a v1 into vw1 plus vw2 into u divided by kinetic energy. So kinetic energy will be what? 1 half mv square. M manje mass and v1 square. So rho a v1, rho a v1 will get cancelled. Last time we have derived. Okay, and this will become formula is become what? 2 into vw1 plus vw2 divided by v1 square into u. Up to this, I think we have covered in last time. So I require 20-25 minutes to recover this. Okay, am I right, na? Up to this, we have covered. So hydraulic efficiency, okay, is given by 2 into vw1 plus vw2 into divided by v1 square into u. So we see m mass flow rate. Mass flow rate is equal to what? Rho into area into velocity. Rho, m mass flow rate, we have defined so many times. Rho av. So mass flow rate and inlet will be rho a v1 okay and this will be kinetic energy will be 1 half mv square so m rho a v1 into v1 square so here power developed by runner rho a v1 into vw1 plus vw2 into u divided by kinetic energy at inlet so this is the efficiency of hydraulic efficiency okay now we have to show that if efficiency for maximum efficiency condition of Pelton turbine how to go for the derivation okay I will take quick review. So VW1 is equal to V1 in Pelton turbine. Okay. Then VR1 is equal to V1 minus U1 or V1 minus U that we are putting. VR2 is equal to V1 minus U. Now we will go to VR2. VR2 is equal to what? V1 minus U. Okay. Because if we are not considering friction, VR2 is equal to VR1. If friction is not considered. So VR1 is equal to what? VR1 is equal to VR2. Therefore, काय येते? VR1 जो आहे तोच काय VR2 येतो. म्हणजे VR2 is equal to काय येणार? V1 minus VR2. If friction is not there. If friction neglected. Maximum efficiency आपण काय करतो? Friction neglect करतो. आपल्या आता condition काय करायची? Maximum hydraulic efficiency. If friction neglected. Okay. Therefore, but VW2, आता VW2 जर गेलो आपण ट्रायंगलला तिकडे याला तर VW2 काय येतोय आपलं बघा VW2 इज इक्वल टू व्हाट हे cos बीटा ओके cos बीटा विल बी एनीबडी VW2 डिवाइड बाय V2 ओके सो VW2 सॉरी VW2 काय केलंय VW2 दे हैव कॅल्क्युलेटेड सो फॉर दॅट दे हैव कन्सिडर दिस एज अ राईट अँगल ट्रायंगल फाय मध्ये लिहिलंय ना तर कॉस फाय जर म्हणलं आपण ह्याला कॉस फाय म्हणलं तर काय येणार कॉस फाय आपण हे केला तर कॉस फाय इज इक्वल टू काय येतोय कॉस फाय एनीबडी कॉस फाय इज इक्वल टू दे हैव रिटन इन कॉस फाय ओनली करेक्ट ना cos phi is equal to kind of u2 plus vw2 and divided by vr2 okay tar aplyala kay paije aplyala vw2 they have calculated what vw2 is equal to kay ate mag ete ga vw2 is equal to VR2 cos phi minus U2. VR2 cos phi minus U2. So this is from diagram they have taken. Okay. So this diagram triangle outlet VR2 cos phi minus U2. But U2 is equal to U. okay, therefore VR2 cos phi minus u, therefore it is VR2 cos phi minus u or VR2 cos phi, but what VR2 is equal to V1 minus u, so VR2 is equal to V1 minus u cos phi minus u, so this is what the VW2 we are getting. Now substituting in equation 5 all these things, what we are getting, eta hydraul is equal to 2 into VW2 value, apply kya karayi chahiye, V1 minus u cos phi minus u, we have to substitute. So here V1 plus, here V1 plus VW1 is equal to V, here we have to VW2 is equal to V1, okay, V1 plus V1 means U1, VW1 chai vi kai keli apan V1 plus V1 minus u cos phi minus u, okay, into u, okay, divided by V1 square. Now what they have done, V1 this is equal to into V1 minus u, okay, V1 minus u plus V1 minus u cos phi into u divided by V1 square. So V1 minus u, okay, what they have done here, this V1 minus V1 cos phi, so V, sorry, this V1 and U, they have turned, let, they have rearranged it together, V1 minus U plus V1 minus U cos phi into U, okay, is equal to V1 square, so, okay, then this V1 minus U, they can take now common, so 2 into V1 minus U, this V1 minus U and this V1 minus U, they have 2 into V1 minus U into bracket, this will become 1 plus cos phi, 1 plus cos phi into U divided by V1 square, so this is a, again one formula for hydraulic efficiency. 2 into V1 minus U into bracket 1 plus cos phi into U divided by V1 square. Okay. Now, this equation is varies with respect to efficiency. We are going to knowing that formula V1, given value of V1. So, therefore, d of du. So, this is what? Equation varies with respect to U only, rotational speed. Therefore, here d of du of eta hydraul is equal to 0. So, this is maximization condition. We are always putting, so this equation with varies with respect, now hachyamadhe v1 kay inlet velocity hai, hachyamadhe inlet velocity v1 kay, v1 is what, inlet velocity, and if phi angles are fixed upper right blade, and u only varying is what, rotational speed jay, it is only varying, so this eta hydraulic here efficiency formula varies with what, u, therefore our here maximization or minimization condition is what, here we have to differentiate with respect to that quantity, variable quantity, that is varies with respect to u, so d of n eta hydraulic we have to differentiate with respect to u and we have to equate it to 0, therefore d of du 2u v1 minus u 1 plus cos phi v1 square is equal to 0, others will act as a constant, tikade sagle 0 asle mane kaana fakt 2u only v1 square little what, so we'll simplify it, okay, so 2u, so this will be what, 2u v1 so 1 plus cos phi is acting as a constant, no problem, so it is equal to 0, so this is r 1 plus cos phi divided by v1 square into, this will be acting as a constant, correct, they have taken this constant 1 plus cos phi d of du of 2u v1 a multiply minus 2u square is equal to 0, so this is equal to 0, therefore it will get cancelled, therefore d of du of 2u v1 minus 2u square is equal to 0, okay, equal to 0 same, okay, now therefore 2u v1, okay, so v his differentiation will be 2v1, 2v1 minus 2 4u is equal to 0, okay, we are getting, or u is equal to v1 minus v2, so the maximum efficiency asnyasati kay kar lagla aplyala, blade velocity should be equal to half of the jet velocity or flow velocity, half of the jet velocity, so state that hydraulic efficiency of a piston will be maximum when velocity of wheel is half, or that wheel manje jet je runner cha velocity is half of the velocity of jet of water at inlet. The expression for max efficiency आता ही आपल्याला पुट अप करायचं आहे. V is equal to V1 minus V2. तर eta max or eta max is equal to what? 2 into V1 minus V2 कुठे आपण गेलेलो आहे मगाशी तो इथे इथे इक्वेशन मध्ये पुट अप करायचं. ओके, और कुठल्या इक्वेशन मध्ये पुट अप केलं तर 2 into V1 minus U plus 1 plus cos phi तर इथे पुट अप केलं 2 into V1 minus V1 minus 2 U 1 plus cos phi into V1 by 2 तर काय येईल हे divided by V1 square. This will become simplification will tell us that 2 into V1 minus V2 minus this will become half. The kind of is a V1 divided by 2 here 2 it will get cancelled. Okay, into V1 आता इकडे जर राहिलेला कुठला हा त्याच्या फक्त V1 by 2 એટલે 2 ला 2 कॅन्सल झाला V1 into V1 काय झाला तो V1 स्क्वेअर झाला आणि V1 स्क्वेअर हा V1 स्क्वेअर विल गेट कॅन्सल्ड 1 plus cos phi divided by 2. So if the maximum capacity turbine chi 1 plus cos phi divided by 2. Understood? So they will ask this MCQ, they will ask what is that? For maximum efficiency, the blade velocity should be half of the velocity of jet, of water at inlet. Understood? Please write. This is a little bit, you have to make practice also one time on paper. I am going to send this PPT immediately after this lecture. Understood? Please respond fast so that we have to. PPT is not there? Yes. Okay. Suhas. Tuani Nani. Yes. Okay. Suhas Nasti. Yes. Good. Others, please reply. Yes, okay. Now, points to remember for Pelton turbine. Okay. The velocity of jet at inlet is given by, actually it is theoretic velocity. Therefore, what? Cv. Actually, this is what? Velocity is what? V1 is equal to what? Root 2 J, but theoretic velocity. But actual velocity, we have to multiply it by coefficient of velocity. Root 2 G H. So, a formula is given. V1 is equal to root 2 A, but this is theoretical. But if it actual velocity will be, this is the actual velocity, we can write down actual velocity. Actual velocity of jet at inlet is given by V1 into Cv into root 2 J, and Cv is coefficient of velocity, and then value getting 0.8 or 0.99. So net head available. Net head available means kaya asto aapla नेटेड अवेलेबल म्हणजे एच जी मायनस एच एफ. जर तो एच एफ दिला नाही तर डायरेक्टली एच इज इक्वल टू जे हेड आहे ते घ्यायचा हेड. ओके, द व्हेलॉसिटी ऑफ व्हील यू इज गिवन बाय यू इज इक्वल टू फाय इंटू रूट टू जी एच. अगेन हे व्हेलॉसिटी ऑफ व्हील म्हणजे फाय हा स्पीड रेशो म्हणाय त्याला. ओके, ऍक्च्युअल व्हेलॉसिटी ऑफ व्हील फाय इज स्पीड रेशो. द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ स्पीड रेशो व्हेरीज फ्रॉम 0.43 टू 0.48. पेल्टन टर्बाइन एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन्वेस्टिगेशन काय सांगते तर स्पीड रेशो वेलॉसिटी ऑफ व्हील इज यू इज इक्वल टू व्हाट दोन फॉर्म्युले दिला आता यू इज इक्वल टू यू वन प्लस यू टू हे पण लिहून घ्या अँड इज इक्वल टू व्हाट पाय डी एन डिवाइड बाय 60 पाय डी एन डिवाइड बाय 60 हे पण आहे फॉर्म्युला पाय डी एन डिवाइड बाय 60 और इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू व्हाट फाय इंटू स्पीड रेशो टू आहे तो इंटू रूट एच. सो हा फाय वेगळा हा स्पीड रेशो आहे. हा व्हॅल्यू त्याची किती असते 0.43 टू 0.40. एमसीक्यू ला देवी लास्ट द अँगल ऑफ डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ जेट थ्रू बकेट इज टेकन एज 165 इफ नो अँगल ऑफ डिफ्लेक्शन इज गिवन. जर दिलं नसेल कुठला तो हा डिफ्लेक्शन अँगल हा आपला बकेट दाखवलाय आणि हा डिफ्लेक्शन अँगल दाखवलाय आपल्याला हा हा थीटा अँगल ऑफ डिफ्लेक्शन. तर दिला नसेल तर 165 याच्यावर दुसरा कुठला अँगल अवलंबून आहे हा जेवढा अँगल इथे येईल हा तेवढा इथला कुठला अँगल होतो तयार हा बीटा अँगल. ल सॉरी फाय अँगल हा फाय अँगल जेवड़ा 180 म्हणून वजा करू तेवढा हा फाय अँगल इज इक्वल टू व्हाट फाय अँगल सॉरी इट इज नॉट बीटा इट इज फाय अँगल This is the angle of DBN. So these points everybody have to remember. Noted. Yes, you have to remember means remember because it is design of turbine. Some parts we have to mark. So velocity of jet at inlet is given by V is equal to CV into root 2 A. Coefficient of velocity CV is value 0.98 to or 99. Velocity of fill is equal to U is equal to phi into root 2 G H. Okay. And so kiti ghayla apun phi. तर फोर स्पीड रेशो आहे 0.43 टू 0.48 आणि अँगल दिला नसेल तर 165 देन मीन ब्लेड व्हील द मीन डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील इज गिवन बाय व्हाट यू इज इक्वल टू पाय डी एन त्यानुसार डी इज इक्वल टू 60 यू इंटू पाय एन त्यानुसार आपण काढू शकतो डी इज डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील ऑर पेल्टन व्हील रनर ओके और मीन डायमीटर ऑर पिच डायमीटर पाय डी एन डिवाइड बाय 60 तर डी कसा काढायचा तर 60 यू डिवाइड बाय पाय एन आता जेट रेशो हे आपल्याला एवढे पॅरामीटर आपल्याला डिझाईन करायचे असतील पेल्टन व्हीलचे कुठले कुठले तर जेट किती लागतील डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील किती असेल डायमीटर ऑफ जेट डी म्हणजे स्मॉल डायमीटर ऑफ जेट किती असेल बकेट किती पाहिजे तर हे आपल्याला एवढे आपल्याला वे हॅव टू दिस पॅरामीटर वे हॅव टू डिझाईन डायमीटर म्हणजे डायमीटर डिझाईन म्हणजे काय करायचं आपल्याला डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील किती असेल त्या त्याला जेट रेशो किती त्याला हे असतील जेट असतील त्या याला पेल्टन व्हीलच्या बकेट रनरला बकेट नंबर ऑफ बकेट्स किती असतील तर ते व्हॅल्यू ओके तर लिहा द मीन डायमीटर ऑफ पी डायमीटर ऑफ पेल्टन व्हील इज गिवन बाय यू इज इक्वल टू पाय डी एन डिवाइड बाय 60 और डी इज इक्वल 60 यू डिवाइड बाय पाय एन जेट रेशो इट इज डिफाइंड एज रेशो ऑफ पी डायमीटर ऑफ पेल्टन व्हील रनर टू डायमीटर ऑफ जेट ओके सो इट इज डिफाइंड एज रेशियो ऑफ पिच डायमीटर कॅल्क्युलेटेड रनर डिवाइड बाय डायमीटर ऑफ जेट म्हणजे जेट म्हणजे काय नोझल मधून डायमीटर डायमीटर ऑफ नोझल ओके अँड दिस इज रनर डायमीटर दिस इज रनर डायमीटर पिच डायमीटर ऑफ रनर याचा रेशो जो आहे त्याला आपण म्हणतो जेट रेशो सो डायमीटर ऑफ पेल्टन व्हील रनर टू डायमीटर ऑफ जेट हा जनरली किती असतो हा 12 फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस हे पण एमसीक्यू साठी उपयोगी होईल नंबर ऑफ बकेट्स किती त्या रनर वर बकेट्स किती असावेत दिस काइंड ऑफ बकेट्स हाऊ मेनी आर देअर हाऊ मेनी शुड बी देअर दिस इज व्हॉट डिझाईन हिअर दिस is given by formula z is equal to here 15 this is standard empirical formula 15 divided by d by 2 d by 2 d but d means 1/2 means going to d by d is equal to m z ratio so 15 plus 0.5 m z ratio calculate kelan chala apun z ratio into 0.5 plus 15 number of jet it is obtained by dividing by total rate of flow through turbine by rate of flow of water through a single jet so everybody have to write this is you have to run the remember always jet ratio again I will repeat it is defined as ratio of pitch diameter d of the pelton wheel to diameter of jet yeah here it is denoted by m jet ratio is equal to d by d In 12 is most of the cases it is find 12 number of buckets on the runner is given by z is equal to 15 plus d by 2d the 15 plus point d by d ka mi z ratio 15 plus 0.5 into z ratio number of jets kay total discharge kiti flow hote turbine marla okay q divided by small q mano apan small q manje kay q manje penstock madhe yanara discharge divided by here टोटल रेट ऑफ फ्लॉप थ्रू टर्बाइन आणि डिवाइड बाय एका जेट म्हणून वाहणार वॉटर फ्लो ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू अ सिंगल जेट क्यू. ओके रिटर्न आई थिंक आय हैव रिटर्न ओनली राइट डाउन दैट फॉर्म्युलेज फ्रॉम दिस. नाउ दिस पैरामीटर मीन्स व्हिच पैरामीटर वी हैव टू डिझाइन इन केस ऑफ द पेल्टन टर्बाइन. काय काय काढायचं असतं आपल्या न्यूमेरिकल मध्ये तर डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील काढावं लागेल आपल्याला. देन डिझाईन म्हणजे काय तर ते बकेट्स किती पाहिजेत नंबर ऑफ बकेट्स किती पाहिजेत जेट रेशो किती असावा आणि त्या डायमीटर ऑफ जेट किती असावा डिस्चार्ज किती असावा ओनली दिस मच क्वांटिटी वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट. नाऊ पेल्टन टर्बाईन हाय वेलॉसिटी जेट डिस्चार्जिंग ॲटमॉस्फिअर प्रेशर हिट बकेट्स वर्किंग आय थिंक वर्किंग वी हॅव लर्न स्टील दीज आर द बकेट्स दिस इज अ स्पियर नोझल दिस जेट डायमीटर दिस इज वॉटर आफ्टर नोझल इट विल बिकम जेट द मोमेंटम चेंज इन थ्रू द चेंज इन फ्लो डायरेक्शन नो प्रेशर चेंज इट पण ॲटमॉस्फिअर प्रेशर आउटलेटला पण ॲटमॉस्फिअर प्रेशर ॲज जेट वेलॉसिटी इज डिपेंड्स ऑन द हेड. ओके सो इट इज अनसुटेबल फॉर लो हेड लो हेडला नाही येते इट रिक्वायर्स हाय हेड आयडियल स्पेसिफिक स्पीड ऑफ टर्बाइन इज वन दे आर की पार्ट्स वी हॅव लर्न फ्रॉम. नाऊ द मेन कंपोनंट्स ऑफ पेल्टन टर्बाइन इज वॉटर डिस्ट्रीब्युशन केसिंग नोझल रनर विथ बकेट शाफ्ट विथ बेअरिंग ऑक्झिलरी नोझल ऑक्झिलरी नोझल इज टू ब्रेक द रिड्युसिंग द स्पीड ड्युरिंग द शटडाऊन. हे डिफरंट लेआउट ऑफ पेल्टन टर्बाइन अरेंजमेंट ऑफ जेट रनर डायमीटर अरेंजमेंट ऑफ टर्बाइन शाफ्ट जेट कसे अरेंज केले जातात कधी कधी इथं असे इथून आज सिम्पल आपला त्याच्यामुळे टर्बाइन म्हणला. ओके दुसरी अरेंजमेंट काय इनलेट पाईप आहे इथं नोझल आहे म्हणजे इथं इथं पण एखादा स्पियर रॉड घालून इथे एक नोझल एखाद वाढवू शकतो आपण अशा पद्धतीचं स्पियर रॉड वेगवेगळे इथं जेट न एक नंबर ऑफ जेट्स आपण काय करू शकतो वाढवू शकतो वन इथं सिंगल जेट आहे इथं डबल दोन आहेत एक दोन तीन चार घेऊ शकतो अशा पद्धतीनं तिथं हे जर आपण कन्स्ट्रक्शन बघितलं तर अशा पद्धतीचे जेट्स असे त्याच्यावर इम्पॅक्ट करू शकतात जेणेकरून पॉवर विल बिकम मोअर. अंडरस्टूड अप टू दिस अंडरस्टूड रिटर्न येस ओव्हर यू राईट डाऊन इफ एनी डाऊट सजेशन एक्सेट्रा इज देअर यू कॅन सेंड बिकॉज वी आर हॅविंग लेस टाइम हेन्स हिअर वी आर लिटल बिट फास्ट येस ओव्हर सुहास गुड अदर्स ओके शुभम गुड अदर्स निकिता नानी शिवानी नानी शर्मिले शिनय शर्मिशा प्लीज गिव्ह युअर फीडबॅक. ओके गुड नाऊ दिस इज रनर विथ बकेट्स दिस इज रनर ऍक्च्युली रनर हाफ हेमिस्फेरिकल कप शेप्ड बकेट इज देअर हा पेल्टनचा ऍक्च्युअल टर्बाईनचा रनर दिस इज ऍक्च्युअल टर्बाईन रनर इज देअर बाकीचे आपल्याला सध्या आपल्याला स्प्लिटर आहे स्प्लिटर विथ स्प्लिट्स रनर कन्सिस्टिंग ऑफ ए सर्क्युलर डिस्क विथ नंबर ऑफ युजली मोर दॅन 15 कारण आपला काय बकेट्स किती पाहिजे आपल्या फॉर्म्युला काय नंबर ऑफ बकेट्स थेड इज इक्वल टू फॉर्म्युला काय आपला 15 प्लस 0.5 m म्हणजे काय आपला जेट म्हणजे ऍटलीस्ट किती पाहिजे 15 तर बकेट आपण पाहिजे 15 प्लस डी डिवाइड बाय 2d. So 15 each bucket is divided vertically into two parts by a splitter that has a sharp edge at the center and buckets look like a double hemispherical cup. Okay, if bucket I did it to this sigma understand actual runner actual bucket is asa hai asa ka total entire is runner striking jet of water is divided into two parts by a splitter hai जे वॉटर आहे ते दोन्ही भागात इकडे निंबद आहे आणि इकडं निंबद आहे हे बकेट नोच मेड अवेलेबल नोच मेड नियर द रीच ऑफ आउटर रिम of each bucket is carefully sharpened to ensure loss of free entry of the jet into small buckets. नॉच हे केलेले जेणेकरून लॉस कमी व्हावा. दॅट इज पाथ ऑफ द जेट इज नॉट ऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड बाय इनकमिंग बकेट्स, म्हणजे प्रत्येक इनकमिंग बकेटला त्याला पाथनं हे व्हावं. बकेटची डिस्प्लेसमेंट कशी होती ते एक डायग्राम आहे. नाऊ विल नॉट व्हेलॉसिटी डायग्राम ऑफ पिल्टन टर्बाइन हे कशी होते. यू ओके व्हेलॉसिटी टेंजेन्शियल डायरेक्शन यू वन ब्लेड मूव होतोय आणि तिथे आपल्याला आउटलेटची ही डायग्राम आहे. ही ब्लेड यू न मूव होते त्यामुळे इनलेट ट्रायंगल कसा आहे तो लाईन डायग्राम आहे. पेल्टन टर्बाइन आपण पॉवर ब्लेड बघितलं का. ओके नाऊ दिस एंड्स द थिअरी ऑफ पेल्टन टर्बाइन. नाऊ विल सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल. हाऊ न्यूमेरिकल्स आर ऑस्किंग. एव्हरीबडी अंडरस्टँड दिस थिअरी. So this PPT I am going to mail you, send on your WhatsApp group. Now we'll go to the solve the problems on the Pelton turbine. One or two problems we'll take and what kind of problem they are asking in the numerical that will cover. Is this notes I'm these notes also I'm going to send on your WhatsApp. So here everything in one cell book only, but written in good manner. So mechanical efficiency, volumetric efficiency, whatever we have learned, this is in detail in these notes. Understood this theory? Please write yes. So we'll start numericals and this. Please give your message, feedback. Okay. Okay. This kind of numericals they are asking. Pelton wheel is to be designed for the following specifications. So I wanted that PPT so that I can use pointer a little bit. The Pelton wheel is to be designed for the following specification. Shaft power is equal to 11,772 kilowatt. Head available for a turbine is 380 meters. Speed is 750 RPM. Whatever this, okay. Overall efficiency is 86%. J diameter is not to exceed 1/6 of the wheel diameter. Means what? Determine 7 mark question. Okay, the wheel diameter, the number of jets required, and diameter of the jet. Take key V1 is equal to 0.9985 and key U1 is equal to 0.45. KV1 means what? Here they have given here speed coefficient of velocity CV. KV1 means what? Apla coefficient of velocity CV and ha phi speed ratio. U is equal to here. U is equal to U1 is equal to U2 is equal to phi into root 2J. Chala a speed ratio 0.45. Everybody getting? Given data, have it okay. Write down the numerical. Is it visible? Is it visible? Yes. So write down and tell me over fast. So 1 or 2 sample numerical will go for. Over. Please write message in message box. Shall we proceed? Response? Okay. Over, over. Okay. Now, here, they want diameter of wheel. One, I will just check that whether PPT is converted. Okay, given now shaft power SP, it is Pelton wheel turn is given to following shaft power SP is equal to 11772 kilowatt. The head H is equal to frictional head. They have not given information. Therefore, gross head we have to consider as 380 meter. Speed of turbine N is equal to 750 rpm. Overall efficiency 86%, 0.86. Ratio of diameter of jet diameter is not to exceed 1/6 of wheel diameter. So D should be equal to here 1/6 of capital D, or D by D is equal to 1/6. Coefficient of velocity CV, KV1 la CV1 te 0.985, and C speed ratio KV1 te 0.45. Now we'll first of all we'll get from this information velocity of jet. Okay, so V1 is equal to your CV into root 2 GH is equal to 0.985 into 2 and CV 0.985 H mahit hai. So my velocity of water jet at inlet will be 85.05. The velocity of wheel kaya assembly formula Pelton turbine la U is equal to U1 is equal to U2 is equal to speed ratio into root 2 GH is equal to 0.45 into root 2 into 9.81 into 38.85. So blade velocity, causality, velocity of blade or tangential velocity of blade. Okay, but U is equal to pi d and divided by 60. Apla paisanda kaya karta hai wheel diameter. Okay, so wheel diameter will get from this now. U is equal to pi d n divided by 60. Is 38.8 is equal to pi d into 750 divided by 60. Therefore, diameter of wheel will be equal to diameter of capla wheel runner is equal to 60 into 38.85 divided by pi into 750 and 0.989 meter is the diameter of wheel. Okay. बट आपला डी डी बाय डी काय आपला जेट रेशो काय एक्सेड व्हायला नको 1/6 पेक्षा. डी बाय डी इज इक्वल टू 1/6. डायमीटर ऑफ जे इज इक्वल टू 1/6 इंटू डी इज इक्वल टू 0.165. सो जेटचा डायमीटर काय असेल 0.165. सो फर्स्ट डायमीटर डायमीटर ऑफ जेट वी गॉट, व्हील डायमीटर वी गॉट, अँड नंबर ऑफ जेट्स वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट नाऊ. नाऊ फॉर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग नंबर ऑफ जेट्स व्हॉट वी हॅव टू डू इज हियर डिस्चार्ज ऍट वन जेट वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट, दॅट इज स्मॉल क्यू विल से. ओके, इज इक्वल टू व्हॉट? Q is equal to area of jet into velocity of jet. So area will be pi by 4 d square into V1. Okay. And D is equal to pi by 4 into d square might apply jet diameter 0.165 square into 85.05 V1. Okay. Then eka jet mun kiti pani discharge will apply? 1.818 meter cube per second. Okay. Now, we are having the overall efficiency is equal to 0.86, and overall efficiency of air turbine is equal to what? Here is equal to shaft power divided by air runner working power of runner, work done by runner. Okay, is equal to rho qgh by rho qgh divided by 1000 kilowatt. Even kilowatt hai kyun, he watt mane kara, he rho qgh hua. Okay, therefore eta overall is equal to sp given 11772 divided by W rho QGH 1000 into 9.81 into Q into 380. Okay, where Q is the total discharge. Therefore, total discharge is equal to what? 11000 equation here 0.86 here. टोटल डिस्चार्ज 11000 आणि किती होतोय 3.672 मीटर क्यूब पर सेकंड टोटल झाला. पेनस्टॉक मधून येणारा हा काय येतो, पेनस्टॉक मधून येणारा डिस्चार्ज इज कमिंग थ्रू पेनस्टॉक. आणि एका जेट मधून किती होऊ शकतो मॅक्झिमम इज इक्वल टू 1.818 मीटर क्यूब पर सेकंड. तर नंबर ऑफ जेट्स किती असतील? टोटल डिस्चार्ज डिवाइड बाय डिस्चार्ज ऑफ वन जेट, देअरफॉर क्यू डिवाइड बाय क्यू इज इक्वल टू 2 जेट्स लागतील. टू जेट्स मागे बघितलं आपण याच्यामध्ये पीपीटी मध्ये की इथं किती जेट लागतात ते, कधी कधी 2 जेट्स आहेत, कधी 4 आहेत. तर इथं अशा पद्धतीचे नंबर ऑफ जेट्स किती असू शकतात? 2. इथं हा एक, हा एक आणि हा एक. अंडरस्टूड काय नाही, फक्त फॉर्म्युले फक्त आपल्या लक्षात पाहिजे, माहित पाहिजे. तर ह्याच्यामध्ये आपण काही ट्रिग्नॉमेट्री वापरलेली नाही जास्त, फक्त फॉर्म्युले वापरून थोडं डिझाईन. एनीबडी हॅव डाऊट अंडरस्टूड प्लीज राईट राईट आय गिव 2 मिनिट्स टाइम टू यू. अंडरस्टूड? काय डाऊट आहे का? बिकॉज फॉर्म्युले ओनली वी हॅव टू रिमेंबर. येस अंडरस्टूड, येस येस गुड. मला ना टुडे आय एम हॅपी बिकॉज स्टुडंट्स आर गिविंग रिस्पॉन्डिंग गुड. ओके निकिता पवार, शनेश्वर मिसाळ, शिवानी नाने, अदर्स प्लीज रिप्लाय सो दॅट आय विल प्रोसीड. हॅव यू रिटर्न निकिता, शिवानी, हॅव रिटर्न ऑर
यस सर.
टाइम? ओके ओके हियर गुड गुड येस ओव्हर. दीक्षा आदमेले, सुहास नसते, गिव राईट अप. आय एम सेंडिंग दिस वर्ड कॉपी टू यू, नो प्रॉब्लेम ऑफ नीड्स नोट्स. This numerical I will give to you on PPT. We'll solve this numerical. This is, I think, this numerical will solve, and afterwards one numerical will take from directly from this. I'll transfer out to your PPT so that we'll get. Okay, let it be. One slide will solve for this. We'll solve. Okay. This is numerical. Now I have to use the pointer, so I will be taking here on the slide the PowerPoint presentation so that I will get on. Okay. Pelton wheel is to be designed. For the following data, shaft power 11,772 kilowatt, head 400 meter, speed 700 rpm. Overall efficiency 85%, jet diameter not to be exceed 1/6 of wheel diameter, calculate 8 marks question May 2016, wheel diameter, number of jets required, diameter of jets. Can you able to solve or I have to help? We'll go for solution. Okay. Okay, then I think 1 minute just we will take this away. This we will take. Same numerical is there for practice numerical, practice purpose. Able to solve? Same numerical. What is given? Pelton is defined, so shaft power is given. So given data, I will write. Shaft power. Eleven thousand seven से 1 2 किलोवाट, ओके, देन हेड एच इज नॉट गिवन, सो हेड इज व्हाट, फ्रिक्शन इज नॉट गिवन, देयरफॉर ऑल योर इज नेट हेड ओनली, एच इज इक्वल टू 400 मीटर, स्पीड गेन इज इक्वल टू 700 आरपीएम, ईटा ओवरऑल इन टॉप डेट 86 देव गिवन 85% 0.85 जेट टू डी बाय डी इज इक्वल टू 1/6, दिस इज जनरली स्टैंडर्ड रूल्स ऑफ दैट, डी बाय डी डायमीटर ऑफ जेट टू डायमीटर ऑफ व्हील 1/6, सो सी वी विल राइट हियर ओनली, ए वी वन डिवाइड बाय वन, बट हियर वी विल राइट सी वी कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी, हाउ मच 0.985 5 स्पीड रेशो यू काढण्यासाठी आपल्याला 5 आपला हा स्पीड रेशो इज 0.45, गिवन डॉट, ओके, नाउ व्हाट दे आस्क्ड अस टू हैव टू कैलकुलेट डायमीटर ऑफ d small d and number of jets, calculation to be calculated. Okay. What is now shaft power rate is overall efficiency. So first of all, calculate V1, velocity of jet V1 is equal to anybody is equal to what? CV into square root of 2gh. Equal to CV 0.985 into 9.81 into H is 400 is equal to something meter per second. Anybody have calculated this? Please tell me value if you have calculated.
87.26.
Once again, yeah.
87.26.
87. Point 26. Shivani, 87 point.
26.
26. Okay. Meter per second. Okay. Then from this, here what we have to calculate? Number of diameter of jet. Shall we calculate here? Diameter of runner. How we can calculate from this? Okay, first then again we will calculate U. U also will calculate. U is equal to here phi wave into root 2 gh. Okay, and is equal to what? Phi into root 2 gh. It is equal to 0.45 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 400. Is equal to anybody? U is equal to coming as anybody? Somebody calculated? Shivani, Nikita Pawar.
39.86.
39.86. 86, okay. 39.86 meter per second. Okay, now we got U, we got V1. But we know that U is equal to what? Pi dN divided by 60. Okay, and therefore U is equal to 39.86. We can here put the values 39.86 is equal to pi into D that we have to calculate into N is what? Here value of N is given as 700 RPM. 100. So if RPM is given, we have to divide by 60. If you are taking RPS, don't divide by 60. Okay, you decide. Okay, pi d n divided by 60. So and diameter of wheel, not J. D, capital D diameter of wheel of Pelton. So D is coming as anybody. Only Shivani is solving. Nikita, others please solve. Tell me the answers. D is equal to. Nobody has solved. D. Please write in message box if you are don't want to unmute. Capital D is coming as only a simple calculation. Too much time we are thinking how we can complete our syllabus. Diameter of runner. Shivani Nani calculated.
Yes, sir.
1.088. Previous numerical and these values are coming same. Okay, near about 1 meter is the diameter of wheel. So first answer we got the capital D. And to calculate small d, what we have to do is there. Here we have to CV we know. So discharge through. To calculate this small d here, what do I do? Okay, that jet ratio is there. D by d is equal to 1 by 6. Why I am taking? So d by d is given as what? Jet ratio should not be exceed by 1 by 6. So d by d is equal to 1 by 6. And therefore, small d is equal to capital D divided by 6 as per the instruction from the numerical. Okay, it should not be exceeded by 1/6. Therefore, it is coming as anybody? only capital divided by 6, so it will get small d, diameter of jet. Jet means it is coming from the nozzle. Understand? Tell somebody, can tell Shivan, you only tell. Other sighting, I don't know what happened.
0.1812.
Okay, now Nikita is giving answer. 0. So Dikshar mile solved. Okay, good. 0.1812. Then we have to calculate what number of jets. Number of jets, for that what we have to calculate? Discharge through small jet we have to calculate. Discharge through jet. Single jet. Discharge through. Discharge through. Single jet. Q is equal to Fenner 5/4 into V. So it is what formula is what? Rho A V1. Basic formula is what? Rho into velocity of area of into V1 is equal to what? Rho of water into
sir. Huh? With us to area of jet into velocity of jet na.
Huh? Velocity?
Area of jet into velocity.
Ah, correct. Area of jet, sorry, rho, mass flow rate is, sorry, 1 minute. Rho will not go, it is mass flow rate. A into velocity, correct. So, rho will not come into picture. So, area into velocity, correct. Sorry, 5/4 into area of jet d square into velocity. V1. What is velocity V1 we got? 87.26. Okay. It is equal to 5/4. D is how much? D we calculated 1.1812. Square into 87.26. How much it is coming now? Somebody can tell.
2.25.
Okay. Meter cube per second. It is flowing through the single jet. But we total discharge flowing through penstock, how we are calculating? Eta overall is equal to what we are calculating here is equal to eta overall is equal to what? How we are calculating? Rho, it is going to be, what is the formula to calculate eta overall? It is shaft power divided by power available at runner. Okay. For runner power, we can say power available. पावर अवेलेबल चाहिए मैं तो शॉट में पावर है टर्नर और रनर पावर पावर है टर्नर एंड इज इक्वल व्हाट यर थीटा 8.85 इज इक्वल शॉट पावर 1 1 से 1 से 1 2 डिवाइडेड बाय रो किलोवॅट असल्यामुळे आपल्याला हे पण कशामध्ये घेणार आहे किलोवॅट म्हणजे आपलं फॉर्म्युला काय रो क्यू जी एच पण हे वॅट मध्ये असते त्यामुळे आपल्याला हे पण किलोवॅट मध्ये ओके अँड फ्रॉम दिस कॅल्क्युलेशन विल गेट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ क्यू एव्हरीथिंग इज नोईंग क्यू इज इक्वल टू मीटर क्यूब पर सेकंड एनीबडी हॅव कॅल्क्युलेटर
3.52
ओके नाउ नंबर ऑफ जेट्स विल बी इक्वल टू व्हाट काय असणार आहे नंबर ऑफ जेट्स
सर 3.52
3.52 कॅपिटल क्यू म्हणजे टोटल डिस्चार्ज पेन स्टॉक मध्ये येणार डिवाइड बाय एका जेटचा डिस्चार्ज स्मॉल क्यू इट इज इक्वल टू हियर 3.52
नो सर 1.57 1.57 सर
3.57
नंबर ऑफ जेट्स 1.57
ओके ओके मग हेच आहे क्यू आपण 3.57 डिवाइड बाय 2. I have to do the calculation, right? Na? Correct, na?
Yes, yes.
It is equal to 1.57. But number of jets are going to be nearly equal to 2. Okay? Did the jet answer? It is nearly equal to 2. 2 jets are equal. Everybody understand? Please write message. Is nearly equal to 2. Yes. Others. Okay. Well, Shivani and Nikita, I don't know. But which others, please promote. Okay. Good. Good. Now we'll go to the World Cup numerical. This, don't worry. I am going to send this. So I think we'll 85838 diameter point. This is second numerical first. This first one. Second one is what? Same numerical but practice purpose. 1. So diameter 0.181. And total discharge number of jets are 1.57, nearly equal to 2 jets. Now last numerical on this. And this will complete our chapter number 6. And we'll enter in unit number 7. This 8 to 10 days we have to complete ISC experimental work. So a lot of work is there. Please be serious. Okay. Now we'll take directly from this. Okay. The Pelton wheel is to be designed. You write down. Shaft power 12,000 kilowatt. Head 400. Speed 800. Overall AP is 90. Jet diameter not to exceed 1/6 of time wheel diameter. Same numerical, I think. Okay, so this is the so we can solve this numerical as a homework. So this formula we have to use and we have to solve the numericals. That is nothing simple numerical they are asked. But everything how we they are giving the right of it given data we should write 3 parameters only we have to calculate Pelton wheel is to be designed for the following data 12,000 kilowatt so just I will you write down this numerical so that I will search some another numerical This numerical you had done as you consider it as a homework numerical. It's same because we, to solve same all same kind of numerical there is no that much investing of time, effective investigation of investment of time. So you solve this. A Pelton wheel is to be designed for a falling 12,000 kilowatt. Asked for activities 2014 old syllabus. The Pelton wheel is to be designed for falling data shaft power 12,000 kilowatt, head 400, speed 800, overall efficiency 90%, jet diameter not to exceed 1/6 of diameter of wheel. This take you take and tell me over. So we'll go to next numerical. One numerical will there on PDF again for more practice. Will not solve so that we'll save our time. Is it okay? Written. So numeric. Over. Then we'll go to next. Otherwise, we'll enter in second 7th unit. Already we have entered because we have taken construction of Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine is over. Over. If it is over, then we'll proceed next. You solve this numerical as a homework and send it on my WhatsApp. Is the write up is over? Over. Nikita Power over. Okay. Others please. Okay, sure. Okay, then we'll proceed for our so important. So first sectional examination. So okay, this is a very good okay. A jet of water of diameter 50 mm, read on. A jet of water of diameter 50 mm having velocity of 20 meter per second strikes at inlet of a curved vane which is moving with velocity of 10 meter per second. The jet leaves the vane at an angle. The jet leaves the vane at an angle of 60 degree to the direction of motion of vane at outlet. Determine the force exerted by jet on the vane in the direction of motion and work done per second by jet. What is given? Who will tell what is given? Jet of water diameter 50 mm. So what is given? Anybody? A pointer is not available for me, so you have to only tell. What is given? Somebody can interact. Diameter of jet is given. And second is what? Speed having velocity of V1 is given. 20 meter per second. V1 is equal to VW1. Okay. Then strikes at the inlet of a curved vane, which is moving with a velocity of 10 meters. So blade is velocity U is also given. U is equal to U1 plus U2. And jet deflection is given. So angle phi is there. It is what? At outlet. Therefore, phi angle at outlet is given 60 degree. and they asked to calculate force exerted by jet on vane in direction of motion. Okay. Now, the diameter of jet here will go. Okay, so diameter of jet is d is equal to 50 mm, 0.05 meter. Area of jet will become a pi by 4 into 0.05 meter square. So this is the diagram is given. U1, this is the inlet velocity angle. U1 is the blade velocity. V1 is equal to VW1. VR1 is only small. So this is our triangle. Deflection angle is what? Here, this deflection angle. This angle is what? 135. But now they are going to deflection angle phi. So phi is equal to what? This outlet. So this is outlet angle means this angle they have given. So beta. At vane angle at outlet. So this is a VR2 making angle. So B here 60 degree. This angle they have given. Okay. Velocity of jet V1 20 meter per second. Velocity of vane U1 10 meter per second. As jet and vane are moving in the same direction, alpha is equal to 0. That we know. Angle made by leaving jet with direction is equal to 60. So here this angle. A 60 beta angle they have given. Okay. For this problem, we have U1 plus U2 is equal to U is equal to 10 meter per second, and VR1 is equal to VR2 because they are not given friction coefficient. So therefore, what friction coefficient is not given. Therefore, VR1 is equal to VR2. Okay. Now from figure, VR1 we have to calculate. What is VR1 value? VR1 is equal to V1 minus VW1. Okay, so V1 minus, sorry, VR1 is equal to V1 minus U1. V1 minus E1. So 20 minus 10 is equal to 10 meter per second, VR1. And VW1 is equal to V1 is equal to 20 meter per second. VR2 is equal to VR1 is equal to 10 meter per second. Now in triangle EFG, EG is equal to VR2 is equal to 10 meter per second. GF is equal to U2 is equal to 10 meter per second. Angle GEF is equal to 1 minus 60 plus 180 minus 60 plus 5. Okay, from the sine rule, EG upon so sine 60 is equal to GF upon sine 120 minus 5. We have to calculate VW2. Or another way also we can use this angle we are knowing. So beta angle we are knowing. So from this VW2 we know, it is V2. And VW2 we have to calculate is 5 meter per second. So use the trigonometry. VR2 we know. This VR2 we know. VR2 is equal to 10 meter. GF U2 10 meter. So EG. So VW2 we have calculated. EG divided by sine 60. Sine 60 EG divided by sine of 60 is equal to GF divided by sine 120 minus 5, or 10. That EG is equal to 10 is VR2. Okay, GF is also 10. Therefore, sine 60 is equal to sine 120 minus 5. 5 is equal to 60 degrees, or you can calculate 5. Another way is 5 you calculate, and after getting 5, here VW2 is equal to HF minus HF. VW2 is equal to what? HF of the calculator, right? It is equal to as to U2. Okay, U2 minus VR2 cos phi. Cos phi calculate. एंगल 60 जेट एक है ओके वी आर टू वी डब्ल्यू क्या है तो 5 मीटर पर सेकंड एंड द फोर्स एक्सर्टेड बाय जेट है फॉर्मूला यूज केला रो ए वी वन वी आर वन म्हणजे वी वन रो ए वी आर वन किंवा वी वन रो वॉटरचा 1000 इंटू 1.9 वी डब्ल्यू वन मायनस वी डब्ल्यू टू आता इथे काय नेगेटिव्ह साईन टेकन ॲज बीटा इज अँड ॲक्यूट अँगल ऑब्ट्यूस अँगल And 1000 into area into 10 and work done fx into u is equal to this much. Okay, so this way we have to solve the numericals. I will send this you this all these numericals and understood so I will send this is homework numerical I will send so this kind of numerical they may ask if offline examination is there otherwise online MCU type questions they will ask is it okay shall we proceed that unit number 6 is completed And unit number 7, we have introduced the 20% part we have completed. Now only analytical part only we have to take. Shall we conclude today lecture by concluding that today we have completed unit number 6. If anybody is having doubt, you can ask. Still we are having 5 to 10 minutes. Otherwise, you write down yes. We can conclude yes or I will give feedback. Yes, was okay, good, good. So we have completed unit number 6 and unit number 7 also. So today we'll conclude. Just give attendance.